Hello, how
Hi,
are you?
how are you?
Great, thanks. And I want to thank you for doing this. You have control over the slides. Let me introduce you. Natasha is reading and writing is her passion. She's got a pretty interesting bio for the particular presentation, right? I like
Do
that.
you think so?
Well, I want to thank you. Oh, okay. Magdalena will come to you next, okay? After this one. And so, Natasha, you have control over the slides. You have 10 minutes. I want to thank you so much for doing this. And I'll let you take it away.
Of course, and I'm going to talk to you about readers, because I love literature and I love poetry and I love blogging as well and reading articles too. So it was only natural that I would choose to talk to you about reading texts and of course fiction, which is my favorite part. So using readers, helping learners read language level simplified readers. Let's move on to the next slide. So why do we have to use graded readers? Well, I believe that reading in another language, not our L1, is a bit, it's a daunting task because most kids have a lot of difficult words that they might not know, some vocabulary use that is way beyond their level. So I believe that through reading graded readers, which are simplified, the reading improves, this reading improves every area of their language acquisition and also helps all four skills at the same time because whatever you read, you can also write on them, you can listen to recordings, audio parts, and so on. It is also very gr a great motivation for students, a nice complement for the curriculum. And of course, we engage them in aspects of critical thinking because when they read something, then you can elicit, you can ask questions, you can ask what they have understood from the characters, if they have some suggestions to make, alter the story, make it more humorous, which is my favorite part, to tell you the truth. I like altering the plots that I read and making them more interesting for kids of a younger age. So I think that the answer to this question, why use graded readers, is more than obvious. Now, what you can do? There are two ways you can do that, and you can use class readers. First of all, you can have readers of the same type, the same readers for every student inside the classroom. That is the idea, so that every kid will have a reader in front of them. On the other hand, if there is a library at school, you can take books, you can even have shoe boxes and create a mini library inside the classroom, like it is exactly what you see in the second photo that I have used to create, mini libraries inside the classroom. This creates something like an everyday contact with the world of books. And of course, that creates, a mini lending library inside your classroom, which makes it even more easy for the kids to reach, to find a huge resource of readers that they might want to read. And you could also create reading clubs, something like competition to reward them after they have read a certain number of readers. That creates, a very a different way of lessons. And I remember one of my favorite teachers that she teaches Greek, of course, which is the country where I grew up to. In order to familiarize students with poetry, which is something very difficult, she has created something like a small bag with small tiny bits of paper with poems written on them. And she gives one poem one no she gives this bag to every student and she asks them to choose one and then they will have to read the poem alive and they will have to dramatize it And this creates a totally different approach of a lesson inside the classroom, which makes it even more, you know, enjoyable and close to something really difficult as that poetry is actually a very difficult task. So besides those ideas, I have tried to find, you know, different activities that you might find useful for your lessons. And I have divided them into three basic areas: the pre-reading activities, the during reading activities, and the post-reading activities. We can all understand that. So for the pre-reading activities, I like Guess the Story from the cover. Not only a reader, but you can also use different covers. For example, my favorite covers are the New Yorker covers. You probably all know them. This magazine, this cover is one of my favorite because it depicts the disaster with the Twin Towers on the 11th of September 1999. So this could work as a trigger to start conversations inside the classroom. And if you do that with your graded reader, then they can guess from the cover, and then you can read the reader and see how close their guess was. Another idea is the jumbled chapter titles, so where you create, you know, small bits of paper and you write the titles of the chapters and you make them, put them in the correct order. You ask them to guess what the chapter might be. And you could also create small competitions to see if their answer was correct afterwards. Also, find about the author. I have included a picture of my favorite writer, which is Oscar Wilde. And of course, you can ask them information about the author. You can ask them the feelings that he probably had when he decided to write particular fiction, particular stories. And you could also visit this site that I have found, which is www.biography.com. It has more than 250,000 biographies that you can use inside your classroom. Photocopy the pictures too. If the reader has pictures, you can enlarge them. You can show them to the classroom. You can ask them to guess who each character is. And then when you actually read the story, then you can see how close their answers were. Now, this is also one of my favorite parts, the comic strips. You could choose a chapter that is funny or not so funny, and you can make it funnier through the comic strips. Or you could create memes. Have a look at this one, the one that I have found. Dorian Gray searches for the perfect selfie, because it's not the picture of Dorian Gray anymore, it's the selfie of Dorian Gray if we want to be modern and, you know, speak their language. Okay, the comic strips and the memes is something that kids are really into these days, so why not give them something that they find really interesting? News and articles too. In this case, the kids will have to be the journalists. They will have to write articles on the plot of whatever they have read. And then maybe you will have to ask them to choose the best headlines so that they are descriptive enough and also effective enough. These are supposed to appear on newspapers. Okay, so this is a very good way to combine reading and writing at the same time. And one of my favorite ones is radio plays. You know what you have to do. If you're also into podcasting, this is something that we also do on Teacher's Coffee. Record them, make them, transfer everything. I mean, change everything into a radio play and record them. Ask them to listen to the plays again, to spot their own mistakes. That boosts autonomy. And of course, they enjoy it. And if they also have, you know, blogs or sites and everything, they can upload their work there into a podcast way, so that you don't have, you know, GDPR issues also. Now, video parallels. If some of the readers that you use also have films or videos, you can, you know, change between the text and the video as well. Horoscopes are my favorite ones. You ask them, for example, I have found something on Harry Potter where, you know, kids will have to guess what is the zodiac sign for each character. For example, in this picture that I found, Hermione Granger is supposed to be Aries. Harry Potter is probably Capricorn. You will have to ask them to spot the features of the character of each different character of the story and try to imagine, according to the features of the character, what their sign will be. And of course, in the character's shoes, this is also an interesting part where you bring the characters of the book inside the classroom and you assign different roles to different kids. And then they will have to be interviewed and they will have to answer being another person to be in the shoes of one of the characters of the book. And that creates also something like a more dramatized approach towards the reading part. Now, the post-reading activities, okay, you probably expect all that stuff because the most common thing that they can use is book reviews. They can write a paragraph for the book or they can, you know, use 1 to 5 stars for each book. And of course, they could create quiz time and that can also be live because you can use Kahoot. You all probably know Kahoot, so use it and make it even more interactive, your quizzes. That's one of my modes, that when I have too much reality, I open a book and then I write something about the book as well. So I hope that was inspiring enough. Thank you very much. These are my mails. And of course, don't forget to listen to us on Teachers Coffee every Tuesday and Wednesday, and you're all invited to join.